Hello again, Orff Ensemble. This time, in this video, you get to see my face and not just hear my voice. You should have watched the other video first, where I take you through the song and teach you what the notes are in Cha-Cha Chihuahua. So if you haven't done that, please stop this video and go back and do that one first. All right. I have to tell you, it's quite lonely in my classroom, and I really look forward to seeing all of you again. But I hope you are doing lots of learning and enjoying yourselves, learning in this new way at home. Okay, so in our song, Cha-Cha Chihuahua, we have five notes that we need to know how to play on the recorder. And I'd like you to pause the video right now and make sure that you have either printed the notes and the music, or you're looking at them on your screen while you're listening to my voice. And when you've got that already, then just hit play again on this video. Okay, so our five notes on the musical staff, on the treble clef staff. I'm going to use my hand for my staff, and you've seen me do that sometimes in class. So these are our line notes, every good burger deserves fries, and these are our space notes, F, A, C, E. And our five notes are F, G, A, B, C. And those are on the document on the blog that is called Cha-Cha Chihuahua Fingerings, Lyrics, and Recordings. So that's where you should be seeing those notes. Okay, so let's start with low F. This is the trickiest one, so that's why we're going to start with it. And it only happens twice in our song, so that's the good news. All right, so let's get our recorders ready. Just go ahead and place your recorder on your chin. I'm going to move this screen down a bit so you can see my hands. Remember, left on top, right on bottom. You're going to put your left hand thumb down on the back. Left hand one down, left hand two goes down, left hand three goes down, pinky does not go down. Now we switch to our right hand. Right hand one goes down, right hand two does not go down, right hand three does go down, and four or pinky does go down. Now three and four are going to each cover two holes. You can see that on my recorder. There are two holes there and two holes there, so you have to make sure you're covering both. If your pinky can't reach, this bottom part of the recorder does turn, so you could move it a bit to help your pinky reach those holes. Okay, so this is F, everything down except the second finger on your right hand. Let's play a nice F together. Repeat after me. Okay, nice gentle blowing, gentle tonguing, okay? And now that's F. Our next note is G, line note G. We should remember G. We're going to just lift all of our right-hand fingers so they're in the air over those holes and leave the left-hand fingers the way they were. So thumb is down, one, two, and three. Everyone say thumb, one, two, three, G. All right, let's do some Gs. Your turn. Your turn. Let's put some Fs and Gs together. So you need to kind of find that spot. I'll start with F, my turn. Your turn. And notice those fingers move all together, not one at a time, when I'm lifting up. And now I'm going to go from G down to F, and I'll put them all down together. Okay, so let's go on to space note A. So that's this note right here, second space, thumb. One, two is A, so you're just going to lift up one finger on your left hand, and again, these stay hovering right over the holes you're going to need for F, but you're not actually covering them, okay? So here's A. Your turn. And now I'm going to mix up some A's and G's and F's. Your Your turn. My turn. Your turn. And you may have noticed even I had a little trouble finding that F at first. One reason is I'm playing with my hands backwards, just to help you in the video. But also it's just a tricky thing to find, so keep those fingers nice and close, so you just have to place them down and you've got the right fingering. Okay, next note. Thumb and one is B, every good burger, middle line B. Let's practice some. Your turn. My turn. Your turn. Okay, and let's practice going from B to A to G to F. My turn. And your turn. I'll finger along with you. B, A, G, F. And then let's stay on F. I'm going to go back up. My turn. Your turn. I'll play with you, or I'll finger along with you. F, G, A, B. Okay, one more pitch, and that is our space note C. There's a lot of those in the song, so we really need to be ready for those. For space note C, all you're going to do with your left hand is you're going to switch from your first finger to your second finger. Just practice walking those back and forth. Thumb and two is C. Thumb and one is B. We never move finger one down to that second space. That is, makes it very difficult for you to switch back and forth. It's just too clumsy and too slow and not accurate, so we don't do that. Instead, we just lift up the first finger at the same time as we put down the second finger. So just practice that movement first. Okay, now let's try playing some C's, but first I'm going to get all my other fingers just above the holes they belong to. And I'm going to switch that second finger, thumb and two, and my turn. Your turn. My turn. Your turn. Okay, here comes the tricky part. We're going to play all those notes starting from C, our top note. You can finger or play along with me the first time, and then you're going to do it by yourselves. Here I go. Make sure my F is all set first, and then lift those fingers. Your turn, I will finger along with you. Start on that C, thumb and two, and here we go. C, B, A, G, F. Okay, now we're going to stay on that F. I'm going to go back up. Turn. Let's start on the F. Okay, here we go. F, G, A, B, C. Okay, so those are our notes that we're going to use in Cha-Cha Chihuahua. That's going to take a little practice. Just spend a little time getting used to those notes. And when you're ready, you can click on my third video, which will be a video of me playing Cha-Cha Chihuahua at three different speeds. I'll play it first quite slowly, and you can play along with me from your music. Hopefully you have printed it out for yourself. I have it highlighted here, and you can do the same. If you need to, make the recorder part one color and the singing part another color. That can really help your eyes know where to go. And then I will play at a medium tempo, and then I will play at the normal tempo along with the recording for the last time. All right, I'll see you soon.